That got a lot of sugar in there, hun. You don't need that.
She got that confidence. She carries that confidence.
Don't need nobody else then. So God says, I need you to look like me. I need that when they hold you up in the light, that it's authentic. I need them to know that you really are living for me and not just trying to get likes on TikTok and Instagram, but you really will say, for God I live and for God I die. I need when the light comes on that they see that there's a mark on you that from a higher authority that says you are certified and you've been stamped by me.
All the time, but it makes me feel comfortable with him, me talking, okay? I feel like I'm doing something, you know? I feel like this lighting is dark. Is it dark? Or am I tripping? Actually, since we're here, I'll read y'all the scripture of the week, because it's a new week, duh. When hard pressed, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. The Lord is with me, and I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? The Lord is with me. He is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in humans. Psalms 118, 5 through 8. And that's the scripture of the week, y'all. I was in my apartment just sitting around, like looking around. And of course, you know, I live by myself. Of course, these feelings of like, oh, I need more friends. Oh, I need this. I don't have nobody here with me. I don't have nobody. I'm sad. I'm lonely. The devil always trying to put those thoughts in our head. So, like, I had to snap out of it. And, like, when I went for a walk that day when I was feeling like that. And after that walk, I was just thinking, just listening to my Bible. And, like, God was just speaking to me within that walk. And he was just telling me, you know, take refuge in me. God is always by our side, because in reality, you don't need nothing in this world. You don't need the people of this world. You don't need the things of this world. You need more of Jesus, and Jesus has so much for you. So you have a lot. We have a lot. It's better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in humans. So don't put all your trust in man, hun. Put your trust in Jesus, the Lord, okay? But sorry if I look crazy. That's what I was saying. Just got back from the gym 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour ago. And then I came home. I prayed. I'm trying to get on top of my prayers, because I prayed this morning. Then I pray after the gym. And then later tonight, I'm going to pray after church, because I'm going to church tonight. And now I'm about to make what I eat after the gym. Welcome to my channel if you're new and all that stuff. My name is Gloria. I was about to make some turkey bacon. I forgot about that. But I don't feel like making no turkey bacon. I don't feel like waiting on that. So I'm just going to make this. I use these protein waffles. And then I'm about to put a banana on top. Cut it up. Make it cute. And then make it cute. What? Nice line. I don't know what I did to my hair, low key. I got a clip. It's a clip. And I clipped it. I'm tired.
Of course, this don't want
to. No.
Oh, shoot. I popped it.
It's still good though. I did pretty good this time. Not gonna lie.
Butter, 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 butter. I like me some butter on my waffles. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I don't know.
Okay, butter on there.
I could have made some turkey bacon, but I surely don't feel like it, honey.
Pow! Banana.
Banana. I'm gonna try to cut this up real cute for y'all, okay? Make it look cute. Make it look cute, honey. If y'all don't put bananas on your waffles, you missing now. Scoot over, scoot over. Man, I can't make nothing look cute. Ugh.
Dance again. I could eat this every day.
But I got on the scale and like, girl, I mean, they said I'm 206. And I was at 210, 211 forever. And like, I'm finally at 206. Like, it's crazy. My goal is to get down to like 190 or at least under 200. Like 190 something, I'm cool with. Some areas in my body I wanna make look better, like my stomach. I do ab workouts and stuff. Some people are already like, girl, you don't got no stomach, but girl, I got a stomach. I have a stomach. Like, I think the title's gonna be better and do better. Oh, my hands are not in my pants, hon. They're just in my pocket, okay? I be trying to like, when I wake up for work, like, I be trying to like not go into my day with like, oh, I gotta go to work. Like, I'll be going to, cause like when you go wake up with that mindset, then it's like your day is gonna be like dragged on cause you're not hyped upon it. Like, I be trying to wake up like just thanking, I'll be like, thank you Jesus. But yeah, I'll be trying to wake up like with a good expectation within my day, knowing God is gonna bless the day, bless you to get through the day, bless you with the joy you need throughout the day. Like, he gonna get you through every task, even though you're gonna be like, oh, I don't wanna do this, I don't wanna do that. But then you get through it, you're like, dang, that was, why did I complain about that when it was just like, now it's done. It's like, I complain for what? God got me through that. And like, I'm just trying to do better within everything of my life, every aspect of my life. Like, usually sometimes when I pray, like, I'm like, oh, sometimes I'd be like having not the energy to pray. And like, I'd be trying to, I said that in my other video, but like, it's like, I don't know, because the enemy's always trying to make you just not spend no time with God. And then if I don't have like, if I'm not excited to pray, I'll be like, God's disappointed in me, because like, I'll be like, oh, I don't want to, because I'll be thinking I don't have nothing to pray about, you know? And like, you always have something to pray about. If you don't feel like you have anything to pray about upon your own life, pray for somebody else's life, if that makes sense. Like, pray for your coworkers, pray for like the people that you work with, pray for your neighbor. Like, of course you can hold a conversation with, you know, your friends and your family. So think about, oh, God is like your best, God should be your best friend, your father, your everything, because he is the head of my life. So I'll be trying to talk to him, like, I'll just be trying to be hyped upon, like, just sitting down and praying. Because like, usually like 100% every time I feel like so much better within myself, within my life, when I'm done praying or in the midst of my prayer. But yeah, I'm just trying to be better, like being better and positive, taking care of my health, taking care of my, going to the gym, staying active. And I started running. I'm starting to jog and run and stuff like that. Trying to watch what I put in my mind within what I watch, like on TV, what music because I listen to strictly gospel music, like only gospel music. It's not good to listen to like a lot of worldly music, music that's not elevating your mindset, like within a lot of cursing, if they talking a lot sexually, if they talking about like drugs and stuff like that. It's not good to fill your mind with that stuff. Like, if you're singing the words to that song or dancing to that music, God's looking at you like, it's like you are praising that music more than him. You gotta examine everything within what you put in your mind and what you put in your life, especially if you're trying to change and be better and live right for God. Because when I first got close to God, like, of course it's like hard because I used to curse a lot. Fun fact about me, I used to listen to everything, like every single genre of music. And the only time I really listened to gospel music is when I was like on a Sunday. Like, that's the only time I like listen to gospel music. Like, I truly wanted him to like get me through a situation in my life and like see him bless me. So I knew I had to give up those things, because I've been going to church for a long time, and like, I knew, like, listen to certain songs, certain music, watching certain TV shows, talking a certain way, acting a certain way wasn't pleasing to God's sight. I saw this thing, it said, don't demand a full-time God but want to be a part-time Christian. I was pretty much raised in church. My mom always told us, she talked about God, like, a lot with us and stuff. And, like, that stuff stuck to me, obviously. I don't know, you always go your own direction, of course. Even if you was raised a certain way, you always gotta, like, have your own experience within everything. When I think of being better, you showing up daily with contentment. What can you do better? Can I do better within reading my Bible? Can I do better within praying more, talking to God more, going to church more? Can I do better within what I eat, my fitness, like being active, staying active, helping somebody out? Pretty much, y'all, I'm just trying to say be better, do better, live better, all state. That's what I'm trying to say. I feel like I did a whole 360 within what I was trying to say. I like watching stuff I can relate to, really. I can't really relate to people cursing 24/7, being negative and complaining 24/7. Because if I'm not trying to do that, and I'm not trying to be like that, then why I'm watching you do that? I'm trying to watch stuff that I can relate to, that's going to help me on my track and my journey of living for God. You want to be an encouragement towards others around you. They see you fit, like, that's going to encourage them to want to work out. If they see you speaking upon God and what God has done for you, what he's doing in your life, then that's going to encourage others to, like, know God is still blessing. God is still here. God is there. God is for us. I keep that in my head. Like, God is going to take you places. Not these people of this world, not these things of this world. God is. God sees your sacrifices. God sees you, see that you're willing to change. If I'm going to be following this person, what am I taking from this person? Is this person taking me to Christ? This person, this thing taking me to heaven? Or is this person or thing taking me to hell? But yeah, I just want everybody to do better, be better, show up. You got this. Do what you need to do to get on track with yourself, with life, with God. Nobody is perfect, but when you're living for God, you are becoming better. So you're always improving on things, but you're never going to be perfect. I said something about stop trying to be someone else and be who God made you to be. When doing good or bad, just know to always live for God. Don't let nothing change your priorities. And that's what I wrote down, like, within what he was talking about. It was really a good word. Sometimes people don't want to go to church because they make mistakes and stuff, and they think they got to be perfect to go in church, when in reality nobody in the church is perfect. Like the pastor, he was talking about how he's not perfect, and church is for not perfect people. Just like, that's why every time you, everybody that goes to the altar, they know they're not perfect. They made mistakes. So they ask, they going up there, ask for prayer, asking for God to forgive them. But money don't make nobody perfect. Clothes don't make nobody perfect. Having a good job doesn't make you perfect. Having the ability to travel a lot doesn't make you perfect. Having the ability to get your hair done, nails done, a whole bunch of nice stuff doesn't make you perfect. Gotta stop trying to be someone we're not. Like, stop looking at other people and thinking you can be like that, because everybody's different. Everybody is unique. God made everybody unique, honey. Because, like, I'm a little crazy. Not crazy like cuckoo like that, but like I just be myself nowadays. So it just like seem like my personality just seems so like crazy, but it's just me being myself. And like, I never was at that point in my life to just be myself, but now that God blessed me with the confidence, he blessed me with the confidence within how I think, like the way he like switched my mindset and how I think towards certain things. When he said, when you living for God, you are a better person. True that. That like, that's that oil stuff I put in my skin, like it makes my skin like glow. So like when I work out, like it looks like I'm like sweating, but so I look like I'm really, you know, in the gym, but really I put some oil on there. I'm hoping like I got some, I don't know, I feel like I was talking a lot, but hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, share if y'all desire to share, and stay blessed. See you guys later. Love y'all truly.